Alright, medics, in today's video, we'll be looking at the rectus sheet. Now, we'll be looking at the rectus sheet in three categories. We'll be looking at the rectus sheet, the formation of the rectus sheet above the costal margin. This particular sheet, what are the structures that form this particular sheet that is found in the anterior abdominal wall? Above the costal margin. Also look at the rectus sheet above the arcuate line. You can say above the arcuate line or between the costal margin and the arcuate line. Either they use the arcuate line or can use the umbilicus. Now the third part is below the arcuate line. As between the arcuate line and the pubic symphysis. That's why we have this third one below the arcuate line. Now we'll be looking at the first part, which is above the costal margin. Now, above the costal margin, let's say this is our rectus, this is anterior, this is posterior, this is our rectus abdominus muscle, and then let's say this is above the costal margin. Now above the costal margin, the internal oblique, their insertion doesn't reach the up to that particular point, the costal margin. Now I'm talking about the internal oblique muscle, because when we talk about the rectus sheet, three muscles come to your mind. Actually, four muscles. We have the rectus abdominus muscle, we have the external oblique muscle, we have the internal oblique muscle, and then we have the transversus abdominus muscle. So now, above the costal margin is the external oblique muscle forms the anterior aspect, the anterior part of this particular rectus sheet, and there's no posterior part to the rectus sheet above, let's say this is the costal margin. We have the xiphoid process here. So above the costal margin, the external oblique muscle, remember, coming from external oblique muscle, is inserted between the fifth, inserted from the fifth rib. So we have, remember the costal margin. The costal margin is from the 7th to 10th rib. So above the costal margin, we have only the external oblique muscle forming the anterior, that's the aponeurosis of the external oblique muscle forming the anterior aspect of this rectus sheet. Remember, this is the rectus abdominus muscle. This is the rectus abdominus muscle. That also continues down, but we'll look at this below the costal margin in the next part. So note this: above the costal margin, the external oblique muscle, the aponeurosis of the external oblique muscle, forms the anterior aspect of the rectus sheet, and there is no posterior aspect. There's no posterior aspect of the rectus sheet above the costal margin. Now let's look at above the arcuate line, or between the arcuate line and the costal margin. Now watch. Let's say this is our rectus abdominus muscle. This is our rectus abdominus muscle. And we have the aponeurosis of the external oblique muscle forming the anterior aspect. Now, the internal oblique muscle, when it reaches, as it was inserted, it divided into two to cover the rectus abdominus muscle. Remember, this is the rectus abdominus muscle. And remember, this is anterior aspect of the posterior aspect. This is anterior, this is posterior. Now, the internal oblique muscle, the aponeurosis, split into two to cover the rectus abdominus muscle. And then we'll have over here, at the posterior aspect, the transversus abdominus muscle. Now, looking at this particular rectus sheet, remember this is above the arcuate line, or between the arcuate line and the costal margin. And looking at this particular rectus sheet, now you see that the anterior part is formed by the aponeurosis of the
external oblique muscle and the anterior aspects of the internal of the aponeurosis of the internal oblique muscle. See, this is the anterior part of the aponeurosis because it's split into two, anterior and posterior parts. So the anterior part of the, this is internal oblique muscle, transversus abdominis, and then this is external oblique. And remember, this middle one is the rectus abdominis muscle. Now, the anterior aspect of the internal oblique aponeurosis and the external oblique aponeurosis forms the anterior aspects or parts of the rectus sheet between the costal margin and the aquate line. Now, the posterior aspect is formed by the aponeurosis of the transversus abdominis muscle and the posterior aspect of the internal oblique muscle. And the posterior aspect of the internal oblique muscle. So this is the formation of the rectus sheet between the costal margin and the aquate line. Now finally, we'll be looking at the formation of the rectus sheet between the aquate line and the pubic symphysis, that is below the aquate line. So see what happens below the aquate line. Now remember, I'll just give a brief listing of above the aquate line, so we'll see how we got to below the aquate line. So we have the external oblique muscle, we have the internal oblique splitting to cover the rectus abdominis muscle, then we have the transversus abdominis muscle forming the posterior aspect. Now, at the level, let's say this is the umbilicus, at this particular point, something happens. There is a fusing. The splitting of this internal oblique muscle, actually, this internal oblique aponeurosis, the posterior aspect, pierces the rectus abdominis muscle to come anterior. So we have the anterior and posterior part fusing together. And also we have the transversus abdominis muscle crossing to come anterior. So something has happened here now. Below the aquate line, we see that so this is the rectus abdominis now at the being the most posterior structure here. So something has happened below the aquate line. Both the external oblique aponeurosis, the internal oblique aponeurosis, and the transversus abdominis aponeurosis, they all lie anterior. They all lie anterior to the rectus abdominis muscle. So all of them, there's no posterior aspect. The posterior aspect of the rectus sheet below the aquate line is actually bare. When I mean bare, none of these particular muscles form the posterior aspects of this particular rectus sheet. So we have been able to establish something in this video that above the costal margin, the anterior aspect, anterior part of the rectus sheet is formed by the external oblique muscle alone. We don't have the posterior aspects. Now, between the costal margin and the aquate line, we have the aponeurosis of the external oblique muscle forming the anterior aspect with the anterior part of the internal oblique aponeurosis, while the posterior part of the internal oblique aponeurosis with the transversus abdominis muscle forms the posterior aspect of the rectus sheet, that's between the costal margin and the aquate line. Now, below the aquate line, all of them lie anterior to the rectus abdominis muscle. That all of them form the anterior part of this particular rectus sheet, both the external oblique muscle, the internal oblique muscle, and the transversus abdominis muscle. They all lie anterior to the rectus abdominis muscle, forming the anterior aspect of the rectus sheet. So that's it about the rectus sheet, the formation. That's it about the formation of the rectus sheet. In our next video, we'll be looking at the quadrants of the stomach, the quadrants of the abdomen, the various quadrants of the abdomen. We're looking at how many quadrants we have in the abdomen and then what and what forms the various quadrants in the abdomen. Now, don't forget to like the video, don't forget to share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.